Now let us go to the topic core data. See the characteristic features of the core data. Let us divide the major characters and minor characters. First, the major characters of phylum core data. Most important character of the core data is presence of notochord. Look at this picture. This green lined structure is the notochord. Notochord is a flexible rod like structure. Then second characteristic feature is presence of dorsal hollow nerve cord. Look here. In this picture, this blue structure is the dorsal hollow nerve cord. This is dorsal to the notochord. See the position of notochord. Notochord is below the nerve cord or ventral to the nerve cord. Then the third character is paired pharyngeal gill seats. You can see here the gill seats which are present in chordata. Now let us examine the minor characters of phylum chordata. First, bilaterally symmetrical. That means the body of chordate can be divided into two equal halves passing through a central axis. The second character is the triploblastic. That means the embryo has three layers: outer ectoderm, middle layer is mesoderm, and inner layer is endoderm. Another character is presence of coelom. The animal is called coelomate. Then organ system level of organization. That means in chordate you can see various organ systems like circulatory system, excretory system, respiratory system, and so on. The other characteristic feature is the presence of post-anal tail. Look at this diagram. Following the anus, there is a projection. This part is called a post-anal tail. Then another characteristic feature is closed circulatory system. That means the blood flows through closed blood vessel. Now we can compare the characters of chordates and non-chordates. First, chordates. As we discussed, notochord is present. At the same time, in non-chordates, notochord is absent. Then central nervous system is dorsal, hollow, and single in chordates, whereas central nervous system is ventral, solid, and double in non-chordates. In chordates, you can see pharynx with gill slits. At the same time, in non-chordates, gill slits are absent. Then heart is ventral in chordates, whereas heart is dorsal. If it is present, that means heart is not present in all non-chordates. Then finally, a post-anal part or tail is present in chordates, but this is absent in non-chordates. These are important differences between chordates and non-chordates. Now let us divide phylum chordata into three subphyla. First subphylum, Urochordata, or this is also called Tunicata. Second is Cephalochordata. Third, subphylum Vertebrata. See, Urochordata and Cephalochordata are referred to as protochordata. They are exclusively marine. Then Urochordata. In Urochordate, notochord only in the larval tail. Then in Cephalochordata, notochord extends from head to tail and present throughout its life. See some examples for Urocodata: Acidia, Salpa and Doliolum are some examples. Let us see the first example of Urocodata, that is Acidia. This is a marine organism commonly called sea squirt. Its length is about 5 to 30 centimeter. Salpa is the second example. This is also a marine individual and fusiform body, that means one end is pointed. The length is about 1 to 5 centimeter long. Doliolum is another example. This is also marine. Body is cask shaped, that means it has a barrel shaped body. Then it is transparent. Then body covered with muscle rings. These are muscle rings. Then length is about 2 millimeter. Next, subphylum is the Cephalochordata. The example is Branchiostoma, or commonly called Amphioxus. This is also marine. The another common name is Lancelet. It has a fish-like body. The length is 5 to 7 centimeter long. Vertebrata is the another subphylum of Chordata. First, let us see the important features of subphylum Vertebrata. There is a vertebral column in the adult. That means in the adult, notochord is replaced by vertebral column. Then vertebral column is made up of cartilage or bone. The heart is found ventral with 2 to 4 chambers. Then kidneys for excretion and osmoregulation. Osmoregulation means the water balance in the body is kept in almost constant or in balance. The process is called osmoregulation. Kidneys play major role in osmoregulation in the vertebrate. Then paired appendages, which may be fins or limbs in vertebrate. Now let us see various classes of vertebrata. First, Cyclostomata. Second, Chondrichthyes. Third, Osteichthyes. Fourth, Amphibia. Fifth, Reptilia. Sixth, Aves. And last, Mammalia. The class Cyclostomata. These are important features of Cyclostomata. Cyclostomes are marine. They are ectoparasites on some fishes, especially on large fishes. They are being attached to the external body. Then sucking circular mouth without jaws. 6 to 15 pairs of gill slits are present. Then scales and paired fins are absent. Cranium, that is a case of brain, and vertebral column are made up of cartilage. Closed circulatory system is present. Cyclostomes are marine, but it migrated to freshwater for spawning. Spawning means for egg laying. After spawning, the adult dies. The egg hatches into larvae. Larva undergoes a series of changes called metamorphosis. After metamorphosis, the young ones again go back to seawater. The examples for cyclostomator, petromycin and myxine. This is petromycin. See, it has a large circular mouth with sharp teeth. This is used for attaching to the body of host, and sucker is used for sucking body fluid. Myxine. This is commonly called hagfish. It has a fish-like body. Now let us examine the characters of chondric thighs. These are fishes. They are marine. Then endoskeleton is cartilage. Mouth is found at the ventral side of the body. Then notochord persistent throughout life. Gill slits are separate. Then operculum is absent. Skin has placoid scales. Teeth are modified placoid scales and directed backward. Air bladder in chondric thighs is not seen. So it has to swim constantly to avoid sinking in water. Heart of chondric thighs is two chambered, one auricle and one ventricle. These are predators, that means they chase the prey and kill and eat. Some chondric thighs have electric organ and some with poisonous sting. Chondric thighs are poikilothermous, that means they are cold-blooded animals. That is, these animals are unable to regulate their body temperature according to the change in the temperature of their surrounding. Then in males, pelvic fins have claspers which help for reproduction. Then fertilization occurs inside the body, so this is called internal fertilization. Then many chondric thighs are viviparous, that give birth to young ones. These are some important examples for chondric thighs fishes. Torpedo, then trigon, scoliodon, pristis, carcharodon. These are some examples for chondric thighs. See the first example. Torpedo. This is a fish commonly called electric ray because it has electric organs and produces electricity. Then a pair of electric organs present in the body of torpedo. Second example is trigon. This is commonly called stingray because it has a long, powerful sting. It may be venomous, that means it has venom. Scoliodon. This is commonly called dogfish, or we commonly call it a shark. It is carnivorous, that means it is a flesh-eating fish. Then viviparous, it gives birth to young ones. Pristis. This fish is commonly called sawfish. Head and skull form a saw-like projection in the front called rostrum. This is the rostrum. Then carcharodon. This is commonly known as great white shark. Its population has decreased very much due to widespread hunting. Another class of fish is osteichthyes. The important characters of osteichthyes are they are marine and also freshwater. Endoskeleton is bony. Body is streamlined, that means the front part is almost pointed, then both sides are curved outward, then again back is almost pointed. Such a structure is called streamlined. It helps the fish to move through water very easily. Then mouth is terminal. Four pairs of gills are present. Then operculum present. Cycloid or tinoid scales are present. The air bladder is present. Then mostly osteichthyes are oviparous. Oviparous means egg laying. The fertilization occurs outside the body, so this is called external fertilization. These are some important examples for osteichthyes fishes. The fishes in the sea are Exocetus and Hippocampus. The examples for fishes in the freshwater are Labio, Cutla, and Clarius. The two aquarium fishes are Betta and Pterophyllum. This is Exocetus fish, commonly known as flying fish. The large fins help to leap out of water into air. Actually, it is gliding, not flying. Another curious fish is Hippocampus. Common name of the fish is sea horse. This is the slowest moving fish. Labio is another example for fish. This is a freshwater fish, widely cultivated in Kerala. Cutla is a freshwater fish. This is also known as Indian carp. Clarius, a kind of freshwater catfish. There are barbels around the mouth. These are barbels of the catfish. Betta, a freshwater fish native to Thailand and Cambodia. Some forms are kept in aquarium. Pterophyllum. This is commonly called angel fish. Angel fish is a famous aquarium fish. Now, let us discuss some questions from the part we have discussed so far. See the first question. Consider the following statements with respect to the phylum Chordata and choose the incorrect option. See the options. A. Presence of notochord. B. Ventral heart. C. Double nerve cord. D. Pharyngeal gill seats. And E. Post anal tail. You have to select the incorrect option. Explanation and answer. Instead of double nerve cord, a single nerve cord is found in Chordata. So, the answer is C, that is double nerve cord. See the question again. Answer is C, that is double nerve cord. Read second question. The following statements regarding the subphylum Urochordata. 1. Notochord extends from head to tail. 2. Notochord is found in the tail of larva. 3. It is marine. 4. It is seen in both marine and freshwater bodies. Of this, A, 1 and 2 alone are correct. B, 2 and 3 alone are correct. C, 3 and 4 alone are correct. D, 1 and 3 alone are correct. E, 1 and 4 alone are correct. See the explanation and answer. Urochordate is marine and the notochord is found in the tail of larva. So, the answer is B. That is, 2 and 3 alone are correct. See the question again. B, 2 and 3 alone are correct is the right answer. Third question. Which of the following is a urochordate? A, torpedo. B, trigon. C, scoliodon. D, myxane. E, doliolum. Explanation and answer. Torpedo, trigon and scoliodon are chondrichthyes and myxane is a cyclostomata. So, the answer is doliolum. Fourth question. Which is commonly called dogfish? Options. A, scoliodon. B, torpedo. C, clarius. D, trigon. E, hippocampus. Explanation and answer to the question. Scoliodon is commonly called dogfish. So, the answer is scoliodon. Fifth question. Choose a freshwater fish from the following options. A, trigon. B, hippocampus. C, torpedo. D, scoliodon. E, cuddla. This is the explanation and answer. Except cuddla, all other options are marine fishes. So, the answer is E, cuddla. See the question again. E, cuddla is the answer. Sixth question. Which of the following statements about cephalochordata is wrong? A, notochord extends from head to tail. B, cephalochordates are marine. C, myxane is an example for cephalochordata. D, branchiostoma is an example for cephalochordata. E, gill slits are present in cephalochordata. Explanation and answer. Myxane is not an example for cephalochordata because it belongs to cyclostomata. So, the answer is C. Myxane is an example for cephalochordata. You can see the question again. Answer is C. Myxane is an example for cephalochordata. Then look at some question. Pick out the correct statements about osteichthyes from the following options. A, osteichthyes found only in freshwater bodies. B, endoskeleton is bony. C, operculum absent. D, air bladder absent. E, placoid scales present. See the explanation and answer to the question. The option endoskeleton of osteichthyes is bony, which is correct. And all other options are characters of chondrichthyes. So, the answer is B, that is endoskeleton is bony. Read the question again. See eighth question. Which of the following is commonly called as seahorse? See the options: A, betta; B, scolyodon; C, trigon; D, hippocampus; E, torpedo. Explanation and answer. Hippocampus is commonly known as seahorse. So the answer is hippocampus. You can read the question again. The answer is D, hippocampus. Ninth question. Air bladder is absent in A, cuttla; B, labio; C, pterophyllum; D, clarius; and E, scolyodon. Explanation and answer. Air bladder is absent in scolyodon, which is a condychthys fish. So the answer is E, scolyodon. Read the question again. The answer is E, scolyodon. The 10th question. Select the fish with the placoid scales from the following options: A, hippocampus; B, clarius; C, cuttla; D, scolyodon; E, labio. This is explanation and answer. All the fishes except scolyodon carries cycloid or tinoid scales. So the answer is scolyodon. Read the question once more. The answer is D, that is scolyodon. Now let us discuss the important features of class Amphibia. Amphibians are aquatic as well as terrestrial. Most of them have two pairs of limbs. Body divided into head and trunk. In some amphibians, tail is present. Skin is moist without scales. Ear of amphibia has tympanum. Amphibians are poikilotherms, that means amphibians are cold-blooded animals. That means they are unable to regulate their body temperature according to the change in temperature of their surroundings. Then alimentary canal, urinary and reproductive tracts open into a common chamber called cloaca. Then amphibians can respire through skin, gills and lungs. Heart of amphibia has three chambers: two auricles and one ventricle. Then sexes are separate. They are oviparous, egg-laying. Fertilization external. The development is indirect. That means there is a larval stage. These are some examples of amphibia. First, rana; second, buffo; third, hyala; fourth, salamandra; and fifth, ichthyophis. Rana. This is common frog. Common frog is friend of farmer, since it eats some insect pests that destroy crops. Buffo. Skin is dry and thick. Its skin glands may produce toxin. Hyala. This is commonly called tree frog. Its long digits have enlarged tips. Salamandra. Salamandra is a tailed amphibian. It can regenerate its lost body part. Then Ichthyophis. It is also called Sicilian. Limbs are absent in Ichthyophis. Now let us see some important features of class Reptilia. First, its locomotion. It is crawling or creeping. Mostly they are tertial. Skin is dry, covered with scales or scutes. Scutes are hard, horny, large scales. External ear opening absent in reptile. Tympanum is present. Two pairs of limbs, if present, that means in some reptiles, limbs are absent. Heart is three-chambered, but crocodile has four-chambered heart. Snakes and lizard can shed their scales as skin cast. Reptiles are also poikilotherms. That means they are cold-blooded animals. They are unable to regulate their body temperature according to the change in temperature of their surroundings. They are oviparous, that means egg-laying. Fertilization is internal, that means inside the body. And development direct, that means development without larval stage. These are some examples of reptiles. Calotus, Chelone, Testudo, Chameleon, Crocodilus, Alligator, Hemidactylus, Naja, Bangaris, and Vipere. Calotus. Calotus is commonly called garden lizard. This is insectivorous, that means it eats insects. Chelone. They are aquatic, commonly called turtles. Limbs act like flippers for swimming in water. Then Testudo, commonly called tortoise, both aquatic and tertial. Chameleon, this is arboreal, that means it lives in trees. Commonly called tree lizard. Chameleon is well known for its color change. Crocodilus, commonly we call crocodile. Snout of crocodile is long and about V-shaped. Lower and upper jaws almost equal in size. Alligator. Alligator has broad and round snout-like U-shaped structure. Lower jaw is smaller than upper jaw. Hemidactylus. Commonly called wall lizard or house lizard. It is capable of regenerating its tail when it is broken. Naja, commonly called Indian cobra, its venom is neurotoxic, that means its venom mainly affects the nervous system. Bengaris. This is commonly called crate. Its venom is also neurotoxic. That means venom affects our nervous system. Viper. This is commonly known as viper. This is viviparous, that means giving birth to young ones, and hemotoxic, that means its venom mainly affects our circulatory system. These are some questions from this topic. First question, poikilotherm means, read the options. A, it is an animal which is unable to regulate its body temperature when temperature around it changes. B, it is an animal which can regulate its body temperature when temperature around it changes. C, its body temperature is always high. D, its body temperature is always low. E, it is unable to live in cold climate. The explanation and answer to the question. Poikilothermous animals are not capable of changing their body temperature when temperature of their surrounding changes. So the answer is A, it is an animal which is unable to regulate its body temperature when temperature around it changes. Read the second question. Which of the following statements about amphibia is not correct? A, it can respire through skin. B, oviparous. C, some amphibians have tails. D, some amphibians have four-chambered heart. E, most of them show indirect development. Explanation and answer. All amphibians possess a heart with three chambers, two auricles and one ventricle. So the answer is D, some amphibians have four-chambered heart. Read the question again. Answer is D, some amphibians have four-chambered heart. Question number 3. Consider the following pairs. 1. Salamandra, legless amphibian. 2. Rana, frog. 3. Ichthyophis, tailed amphibian. 4. Hyala, tree frog. Of this, A, 1 and 2 are correct. B, 2 and 3 are correct. C, 3 and 4 are correct. D, 2 and 4 are correct. E, 1 and 3 are correct. See the explanation and answer. The correct pairs are Salamandra, tailed amphibian. Rana is a frog. Ichthyophis is a legless amphibian. Hyala is called tree frog. So, the correct answer is D, that is 2 and 4 are correct. See the question again. Fourth question. From the following statements regarding the characters of reptilia, choose the incorrect option. A, poikilothermous. B. Direct development. C. Respiration through skin. D. Most of them have three-chambered heart. E. Mostly internal fertilization. Explanation and answer. Reptiles are unable to respire through skin because it is dry. So the answer is respiration through skin. Next, fifth question. Pick the snake from the following options. A. Chelone. B. Hemidactylus. C. Testudo. D. Bangaris. E. Calotus. Explanation and answer. Bangaris or crate is a highly poisonous snake. So, the correct answer is Bangaris. Look at the question again. The answer is D. Bangaris. Now, let us see the important characters of aves or birds. Feathers are present in aves. Most of them fly except flightless birds. They possess beak. Forelimbs are modified into wings. Legs are adapted for walking, running, clasping on tree branches and swimming. Forelimbs carry scales. Oil gland at the base of the tail. The birds use this oil to make the feathers smooth. Endoskeleton fully ossified. That means very closely joined. Then long bones are pneumatic. That means air cavities are present. This reduces the weight of the body. Digestive tract has croup and gizzard. This is used for grinding the food well. Heart is fully four-chambered. That means two auricles and two ventricles. They are homeotherms. That means warm-blooded animals. That is, the birds can regulate its body temperature according to the change in the temperature of their surroundings. Air sacs are connected to lungs. This is for efficient respiration. Sexes are separate. The fertilization takes place internal. Direct development, that means there is no larval stage in the development of birds. These are some important examples for aves. Corvus, Columba, Sitacula, Struthio, Pavo, Aptenodytis, Neophron. See Corvus. There are two species of crows. House crow and jungle crow. Jungle crow is dark black with heavy beak. You can see here. Then house crow with grey colored in the neck region. This is house crow. Columba. This is commonly called blue rock pigeon. This is monogamous. That means one male cooperates with only one female. Sitacula. This is commonly called parakeet. It has long tail and red beak. Struthio. This is commonly called ostrich. This is the largest flightless bird. pavo. Commonly called peacock, the female is peahen. The male has long tail feathers. Aptenodytes. This is a flightless bird, commonly called penguin. The forelimbs are modified as flippers for swimming. Neophron. This is commonly known as vulture. This is a scavenger. It eats mainly dead bodies of animals. Then the characters of class Mammalia. Mammals are found in variety of habitats. Polar ice caps, deserts, forests, mountains, grasslands, and dark caves. The mammary glands are present in all mammals. The young ones get milk from mammary glands. Two pairs of limbs are present. They may be adapted for walking, running, climbing, swimming, and flying. Hair is present in the body of mammal. External ear or pinna is present in mammals. There are different types of teeth in the mammalia. Heart is four chambered, two auricles and two ventricles. Lungs are respiratory organs. The sexes are separate. Fertilization is internal. Viviparous and few oviparous mammals are there. Their development is direct, that means there is no larval stage in the mammalia. These are examples for mammalia. Ornithorhynchus, Macropus, Pteropus, Camelus, Macaca, Rhetus, Canis, Felis, Elephas, Equus, Delphinus, Balaenoptera, Panthera tigris and Panthera leo. These are some examples for mammalia. First example, that is Ornithorhynchus, commonly called duck-billed platypus. This is an oviparous mammal. Macropus. This is commonly called kangaroo. Marsupium is present. It is a pouch below the abdomen, and young ones are kept in this pouch. Pouch is called marsupium. Pteropus, commonly known as flying fox. It is frugivorous. Bats are only truly flying mammals. Camelus, commonly called Indian camel. A single hump on the back is an important character of Indian camel. Macaca, commonly called bonnet monkey. This is endemic to South India. That means this is found in South India an animal which is found in a particular area or particular region is called endemic to that region. Macaca is found in South India. So, this is endemic to South India. Rattus, commonly called house rat. As we know, it spread various diseases like wheals, plague, etc. Canis, domestic dog is the first domesticated animal. It can spread rabies. Felis, house cat is the most popular pet in the world. It has retractable claws, that means it can withdraw its claws. Elephas, there are two species of elephants in the world. One is Asian or Indian elephant and second one is African elephant. African elephant is bigger than Asian elephant. Equus, man began domesticating horse around 4000 BC. Horse can produce sweat for cooling the body. Balaenoptera, commonly known as blue whale. This is the largest animal on earth. Panthera tigris. Tiger is our national animal and it is a great predator. It is highly endangered thanks to hunting and habitat loss. So, we have tiger projects to protect our tigers. Panthera leo. In India, lion lives only in the Gir National Park. Lion also faces threats from man. This is highly endangered animal. Let us examine some questions from this topic. Consider the following statements with respect to apes and choose the incorrect option. A option, presence of feathers. B, homeotherms. C, legs without scales. D, oviparous. E, development direct. Explanation and answer. Birds possess scales on their legs. So, the answer is C, legs without scales. See the answer C, legs without scales. Second question. Read the following statements regarding class mammalia. One, all mammals have mammary glands. Two, all mammals are oviparous. Three, they have four-chambered heart. Four, they are homeotherms. Of this, A, 1, 2 and 3 alone are correct. B, 2 and 3 alone are correct. C, 1, 3 and 4 alone are correct. D, 1, 2 and 4 alone are correct. E, 1 and 4 alone are correct. Explanation and answer. Most of the mammals are viviparous, but a few are oviparous. So, the answer is C, 1, 3 and 4 alone are correct. Read the question once more. Third question. Choose the oviparous mammal from the following options. A. Ornithorhynchus. B. Macropus. C. Pteropus. D. Camelus. E. Macaca. Explanation and answer. Ornithorhynchus is an egg-laying mammal, and all other mammals given in the options are viviparous. So the answer is Ornithorhynchus. See the question once more. Answer A, Ornithorhynchus. Fourth question. Which of the following is a flightless bird? A. Corvus. B. Columba. C. Sitacula. D. Neophron. E. Aptenodytis. Aptenodytis or penguin is a flightless bird. So the answer is Aptenodytis. See the fifth question. Which of the following statements is correct? A. Mammals and birds are warm-blooded. B. All birds are not oviparous. C. All mammals have external ear. D. Some birds lack feathers. E. Some birds show indirect development. Explanation and answer. All mammals and birds are homeothermous or warm-blooded. So the answer is A. Mammals and birds are warm-blooded. Read the question once more.